I got 45 to 55 minutes with you. And I'm gonna enjoy it till the judge calls time. Stand up and fight me, spider freak! What in tarnation are you doing up there?
Staying away from you. By the way, did Billy and Clix Bruce buy that costume for you?
Why, you little... You get down off that cage and I'm gonna fly and leap. I'm gonna slam. I'm gonna submission. Oh!
Well, deal's a deal, Spider Kid. You did pretty good. Your brick of Spider-Man will be in the mail soon. Oh, and by the way, 90% of the set got spoiled on eBay.
The whole set was spoiled on eBay? My unboxing video is gonna be worthless!
Yeah, I forget the part where that's my problem.
All the chases! Put them in the bag!
Take them, they're yours! Hey, somebody stop him!
Thanks, kid.
What the heck, kid? You could have stopped him!
Yeah, I forget the part where that's my problem.
Oh, hello, and welcome back to another Dial H Heroclix unboxing. Today, it's Spider-Man Beyond Amazing. And we're hoping for some amazing pulls, for sure. but first things first, obviously, the Legacy card.
Oh, yeah. Let's take a look at it.
This could be something big.
This could be big time.
It could also be one of these fellas.
Oh, it's not going to rip there. Oh, I got it at the bottom. Whoops. I can feel the card. I got to do what Kalder does, who, by the way, is out of town. Yes. So that's why I'm filling in. Let's
also
see what we got.
Ian's birthday, so.
Oh, baby!
A stilt man.
Stilt man. We're super happy about that.
De Rocher, that has been a collector of stilt men for a while.
Yes, we do have a member in our Discord, Bill, who has collected, I think, like 18 of these, I want to say, something like that. So very cool. It's a folding card. Something interesting about this one, though, Simeon, is he is 49 points. So if you were planning on saving that extra point on your build, maybe take a look at Stiltman.
Yeah.
He's got some fun abilities.
Many tournaments have been won and lost over an underbuilt team. Just like, you know.
Yeah, you 299 know. Instead of 300. It's so, strategy.
Yeah, it's a real strat. You play Stiltman instead of Sakari and Iron Man. Might be the way to go. All right. Well, we're going to start off. Are we going to be playing with these boosters when we're all said and done?
I think we might film a match or two, so stay tuned with that, guys.
And
it
normally,
should be pretty fun.
We would be giving one of the first super rares away, but you're going to have to stay tuned to the IPF, because some of this product might end up on the IPF's giveaways and the tournament, so make sure to check that out. We'll get more into that later, but we're starting with the back left.
Yes.
For booster number one. We have a Kraven, we have a Chameleon, a Miles Morales, a Moon Knight, and a Spider-Gwen. We also got one of those very nifty little hint cards that Wizkids has been packing in these. This one
I really like these.
Mysterio and Bombastic Bagman, which, yeah, I don't know why they team up well, but they'll tell you. It's a nice little blurb that they put for these guys. And it actually, a few of them did make sense when I was like reading. I was like, oh yeah, that does combo. That's
you know,
cool.
As a new player, like reading some of that stuff, you know, if you've been playing for a while, some of it's a little more obvious. But if you're newer to the game, reading about like how a rally can be a little more beneficial, or just like the functionality of rally, that might clear things up a bit for newer players. So
definitely.
I'm all for it. I also like how they're linking their socials on the back. I'm all for the promoting of that. So yeah, I think it's a great addition.
Help find stores. Takes you to like the wind system, stuff like that. Yeah, pretty neat.
Kraven, pretty solid figure. Not too bad.
Kraven's gonna be
Pulled him in our video. I didn't play him, but
yeah, he's got the grand hunt trait, and then of course, like most Sinister Syndicate characters, he's got the rally 6 die. So his rally die gives someone a prey token, and then of course the grand hunt lets him increase attack and damage against characters that have a prey token, and when he hits, they get immobile. Then he's got charge, stealth, flurry, but only to target an opposing character with one or more action tokens. He is a very economical beast. I think it's sealed for 50
points. He's
pretty
nasty. He's
pretty gross, yeah.
I think outwit in sealed is very strong for the set, just with how much like super senses there is, and then making it like a 4 through 6 with the new Spider-Man TA changes. So I'm a big fan of Kraven character-wise, and yeah, just dial-wise as well. We'll do the back right now. We'll see what we have cooking here. It could be anything. Really taking my time with this one. All right. We've got, the rare Punisher with the dual katanas.
Oh, yes.
The McDonald's Daredevil. I don't know what you want to call him. Another chameleon. And then Aunt May, who some people are really crazy about. I think support might be coming back with her. She's real good. Yeah. And Matt Murdock, the blind lawyer. So we'll take a look at Punisher quick. And then, as always, another hint card. But we don't need to get into that again. Ooh, all right. So, the Punisher here, he's rocking some leadership, mastermind, stealth, all as a trait. And then when he has, when the Punisher uses leadership and succeeds, you may instead generate a 0-5 hand ninja or a 0-21 hand ninja on click 1. If a 6 was rolled, you may instead generate both. So this guy is pumping out a lot of different figures. He's also got Blades, Claws, Fangs, and Pen Size, and Attack Ability, and then Empower and Range Combat Expert. For 75 points, solid mob boss. He features some wild card TA as well, and then Masters of Evil, which the hand ninjas feature that as well. There isn't one in this pack, though, which that's kind of unfortunate, but
yeah.
That's okay, too.
You don't pull the minion that you need. You can play that Punisher and the evil Matt Murdock. There's 4 Matt Murdocks.
Yeah, there's a lot of Daredevil.
So you can play the evil one, and they both have a trait that brings in hand ninjas, so you can double your hand ninja capabilities. All right, booster number 3 coming from that front left pocket. I can already see we've got some beetle action. So we've got the rare beetle, we've got that hand ninja we were just talking about. This is the common one, the stealth smoke cloud. Nice. We have Venom, the big beefy Venom. We have a Gwen Stacy, and we have J. Jonah Jameson, and then another hint card. So yeah, we've got, in this booster alone, we've got stealth, free smoke cloud, we've got perplex, we've got a leadership. We've got another leadership with flight.
This would be great for sealed.
Yeah, this is a solid pack for sealed.
Really good.
Beetle, of course, being one of the leaders of the Sinister Syndicate from time to time. Frightful 4, Masters of Evil, Sinister Syndicate, Thunderbolts, Armor, and Scientist keyword. So Beetle gets friendly characters that are adjacent or have the Sinister Syndicate team ability. When they attack, you can remove one of Beetle's rally dice and re-roll the attack roll. So it's like a map wide rob. Yeah, if
and
you're
it's
already
got a
building,
great paint app too.
Oh yes,
a beautiful look.
The wings popping out, the shell. It definitely like looks more Beetle pod opening and actually flying than normal. I really
the
like
color
this one
too.
Yeah, I tried to play this.
Yes, you did.
It died quite quickly, but. But for Sinister Syndicate players out there, that is definitely one that you'll want to add to your collection if you're building, especially out of this set.
Yeah. And also that Venom I have to comment on. Finally, we get a Venom that's like the correct size.
The correct size.
I love his look.
Super strength, exploit. He heals whenever somebody uses super senses, which Spider-Man is like his main,
Not even if they miss nemesis or succeed, just use. So
yeah.
That Venom, I played him in sealed. He had some staying power. He was hitting hard with objects, some exploit. Mm-hmm. Man, it's a shame that the best Venom we have is a common, but I'm happy to get another good Venom. So, all right, on to the next booster. No super rares or chases yet, Simeon.
No, we're saving the best for last, I think.
Could there be, is it one in this pack?
Whoa!
Okay! All right! Oh, wow. Okay, so let's go down the line quick. We've got Mary Jane, common, Sandman common, we've got the Prowler uncommon, Doctor Strange rare, and then the super rare prime Iron Spider, who people have been, I'd say, pretty split on.
Yeah.
There's some people who are really big on this guy and others who are just not seeing his potential. Simeon, where do you stand?
I think, because like the whole like, oh, he takes your prime slot, I hate that argument.
I do too.
Personally, I think if your team benefits and like in an extreme way, you don't need Destroyer, you don't need Mad Gym, he is incredibly good.
He's got a lot of utility. And we'll take a look at what he does real quick here. He has friendly characters have Sinister Syndicate. If they already have Sinister Syndicate team ability, they have Safeguard Outwit. So something I've heard pointed out is if you play a figure like the 30-point Flash from Wonder Woman who has a 12 attack, your whole team can borrow a 12 attack, like no keyword requirements. Everyone has Sinister Syndicate. If you're already playing Sinister Syndicate, giving them all Protected Outwit on those crucial rollouts, people like Doc Ock with Mastermind, that can be huge. But other than that, he's also rocking Charge, Flurry, Plasticity, Stealth as a move special, which is pretty deadly. He ignores elevated in characters on movement, and then he also has a damage ability, which is another potentially like really warping power. He's got Leadership, Outwit, Shape Change. When Iron Spider uses Leadership and succeeds, until your next turn, he has opposing characters within range, not line of fire, can't use the effect of equipment. Wow, this guy's pretty nasty, and look at that sculpt. This is a figure that we definitely have to pop out.
Yeah. Obviously, he's not fitting on every team.
No.
But like I was just talking about with that Beetle, this is like a figure that if you're running Sinister Syndicate,
pictures.
You want to pick him up.
Definitely.
He's also, just an amazing sculpt.
That gold is, looks really good, man. Well, all right, Iron Spider, we are happy to get him. And yeah, as far as the argument goes, like Simeon said, he's not going to be on every team, but the ones he is on, he might be pretty nasty, because another thing, he can be played at 75 or 30, so if you want to play him as an attacker, you can do that. If you want to play him as more of a support piece that stays back, totally fine too. I really like this guy, and I love his sculpt. What's his real name is Aaron Davis. I wasn't familiar with who this was.
Yeah, I'm not completely
so
familiar
So that's
either.
Also Prowler, isn't it?
I think so.
Let's check.
I want to say Prowler.
It is,
yeah,
yes.
Prowler is Aaron Davis from the Ultimates universe, and then that must be like 616 or something.
Oh, sure.
I don't know, but I mean, yeah, he like maybe stole one.
Scott Porter. We don't have all the knowledge.
He stole one of the spider suits, possibly. I like to speculate more than know. Oh, I see some bubbles, so we might have something interesting here.
What do we got?
Ooh, it is a Green Goblin.
Oh, nice!
Not a Hobgoblin, a Green Goblin.
Man, that sculpt is beautiful. Wow.
The amount of smoke and fire.
He's so high up there, too.
Yeah, he is. He's...
Dang.
He's pretty tall. All right, so in this pack, we got Matt Murdock, we got Hydro Man, we got Mr. Negative, and we got a rare Bombastic Bagman. And
this
then,
is
of course,
a great pack.
Green Goblin, yeah. I think them keeping adding like rares in with super rare packs is pretty crazy. Really ups the value of a super rare pack. But I'll go over Bombastic Bagman real quick. Because he's one of my personal favorites. So, it's Peter Parker with a bag on his head and a Fantastic Four suit. So, yeah, he's got, when establishing theme teams, characters on your starting force with the Fantastic Four keyword gain the Spider Family keyword. So, one more character that adds to the Spider Family.
That could be nasty.
He has a green rally four, which means opposing and friendly dice. Anyone that rolls a four, you get free, remove one of Bombastic Bagman's rally dice. If you do, until your next turn, Bombastic Bagman has... When a friendly character within range is KO'd after resolutions, heal all friendly characters one click.
So he's basically handing out the Fantastic Four to you.
Essentially. But in my opinion, it's better than that because we have, like, constructs and we have...
The
lock arms. We have so many, like, the tentacles. We have so many things where...
Yeah, die so easily.
You can easily, like, kill something on your own turn. And you like activate this rally first, and then everyone just burst effect. Everyone gets.
I didn't even think about that. Just killing off your own set on like a map like Bifrost too.
Yeah.
We're just running the paparazzi into the special. For those of you who don't know, if you end your turn in like this special terrain on Bifrost, it KOs the figure. So you can just suicide things to heal your team. That's what I'm getting at.
Yeah.
I love that. That's
awesome.
I think
he's great for that. He's got a 75 and 35 point dial, and I think he really fits at 35. And then he's got a stop click that stops super senses when Bombastic Bagman uses it and fails. After resolutions, you may deal damage to the attacker equal to the result. If Bombastic Bagman has four or more rally dice, the damage dealt is penetrating.
Now, hold on. He's got that trait, which, you know, is in reference to the old Kick Me Bagman from Web of Spider-Man, but he does not have the Kick Me sign on his back.
No old Kick Me sign.
Boo.
Yeah,
that's okay.
It does say for old time's sake on that power, though.
Ah.
Yeah.
So maybe he's... I used to have the sign on me.
Yeah.
Not anymore.
I used to take hits. Green Goblin now. I'll keep this one a little shorter. He's only got two things going on. So he's got 3 point values, 100 points, 75, and 40 point line.
Gosh, I love that.
Really long dial, 9 clicks total. He has a rally trait that is, just gives him perplex. And then he's got the free, remove one of his rally dice. If you do, when he uses perplex, you can modify an opposing character's combat value by -2 instead. And if they have the Spider-Man family keyword, you can instead modify all combat values -1.
That's just nasty.
Super nasty. The in prime sealed? Version is perplex, but you increase a combat value by +2. So it's like the opposite.
Oh, okay,
effect.
Sure.
And then his other trait is leadership. At the beginning of the game, you may replace up to 5 other friendly characters with the same number of characters from your sideline on their starting clicks. All replacement and replaced characters must have the Sinister Syndicate keyword and different names. Total points of the replacement characters can't exceed the total points of the replaced characters. So it's Sinister Syndicate swap.
Mm-hmm.
He's really cool. He fits in at a lot of point values. You can have him as a main attacker. You can have him as like a tertiary close attacker. I don't like the 75 point line, but it is an option. And then of course the 40 point line, the most economical one.
It's probably what people will get at the most, I imagine.
Yeah.
But yeah, Sinister Syndicate swap. I'm interested to see what people cook up with that. I think there could be something there, but you know, regardless, that is a beautiful looking piece. That might be arguably like the best sculpt in the set. That is beautiful.
Yeah, and real name qualifies for the pumpkin bombs.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
So if you pull those, yeah.
If I pull those?
If you pull
them. Is that a challenge?
Oh.
Did I actually? Okay, hold up. Oh no, it's the shocker gauntlets.
Okay. I was gonna
so
say,
close. I was like, no way, dude.
I saw Hobgoblin. I was like, maybe.
Another goblin. Wow. This was one of the supers I was more excited for. And I'm also really excited that it's not broken. I have seen this piece come broken in quite a few different
ways. He doesn't have quite as much flame to attach to.
Yeah, it's a very skinny attachment on that.
Yeah.
And we'll, you know, do some zoom ins as well. But yeah, let's... Oh, I suppose we should go over what the booster actually is. We have Spider-Gwen, Aunt May, Miles Morales, Boomerang, who I love this suit. Like the new Boomerang looks... I mean, I just like the design of it. And then Hobgoblin, who, yeah, seriously, he looks sweet too. So we'll take a look at Hobgoblin. He's got a fun rally ability.
And I learned Boomerang has flight because if you look back in like the early comics, he has jet boots.
I wondered about that.
Somebody messaged us and informed me that, yeah, he used to have jet boots. Or maybe still does. But
the more you know.
Yeah.
So we'll take a look at Hobgoblin quick, and then these Shocker Gauntlets as well. So Hobgoblin, he is rocking Shape Change. When Hobgoblin uses it, before rolling the die, you may remove any number of Hobgoblin's rally dice to increase the result of the roll by +1 for each rally dice removed. Still fails on a 1. If you do and he succeeds... After resolutions, turn his dial to click number 1, protected outwit. So, I mean, you got to hit this guy hard and fast. Otherwise, if those rally dice start stacking up, he's just going to keep going back to that first click. And I really wish this had, like, a flavor name for this, because it's like, why is he healing back? Is it because it's a new Hobgoblin? That's my assumption.
He, like, he changes
his shape.
It's
like a new mercenary.
Like, yeah,
know?
Okay. So that does make sense.
Maybe that's what it is, where it's like you can't kill the Hobgoblin because technically, like, nobody's Hobgoblin.
Sure.
There's a few people who are, you know, more so than others. But anyway, he's also got a damage special, which is Leadership Range Combat Expert. And his dial is pretty solid for 50 points. Some running shot, double target, energy explosion. He can start with those pumpkin bombs to help out with that. But Yeah, really solid sculpt. Another super rare that I definitely wanted to see. So we are happy to get that here. And then the Shocker Gauntlet. Let's take a look at that. It is indestructible. Qualifying name, Shocker, meaning you can equip it to Shocker for free. Yeah. Qualifying keywords, none. Equip any unequipped drop. Effect, Force Blast. If this character can already use Force Blast, when they use it, they may also knock back each opposing character that was adjacent to the chosen character. For 5 points, it's not too bad. That's pretty interesting. Yeah. I mean, knockback damage coming back into the game, that could maybe be something for somebody.
Yeah. And if we pull a Shocker, get into a little bit more.
No, I don't think so.
But yeah, we'll get into a little bit more of the potential that those have. But definitely, I like all the equipment that they made in this. It didn't feel, other than like the web shooters, we hadn't seen most of it before. Mm-hmm. And then of course we'll
the
see
pumpkin
the
pumpkin bombs were in.
That's true.
Those were in Venom Carnage.
Yeah.
These ones are better, I think, because they make your energy explosion 3 damage.
3 damage, yeah.
Hopefully we pull those.
Ooh, oh boy.
Oh gosh.
We got her.
Oh my.
what an unboxing to miss, Kalder. Wait, do we have Kalder?
And are we good? Are we good? Okay, I think we're live. Hey guys, what's up? Kalder Ness here. Sadly, not in the Dial H studio right now. Even though I'm over 500 miles away, I am still so pumped that the guys just pulled Gwenmerica, and I can't wait to get back to the studio so I can play her in some games. Man, I'm so pumped. I cannot wait to see what else is in this brick.
Okay. Well, if he said something, I'm sure it was great. but in case he didn't, we have Spider-Man, the common Black Cat. We have the uncommon Speed Demon, the rare Electra Nachos as Daredevil. And then, of course, we have the Chase Gwen America with her
Woo!
Shield guitar and
Very
her
cool.
flowing locks. When we were going over the set list...
she's probably the best Gwen Chase, I think.
She's one
I
of
really
them.
Like her.
She's definitely like in the top. Because if you look at like what the Spider Gwen can turn into, like if you look at them all as that, it kind of varies. But as far as like point for point, her 35.
She's got the lowest dial.
Really
yeah.
good. Yeah.
The leadership with like no adjacency or line of fire is.
Yeah.
We'll let you get into that. it's pretty
no.
crazy. It's
yeah,
pretty crazy.
It's, so of course she's got the Spider-Man family team ability, but then she has a trait that is rhythm guitar, power chords, because they're all part of a band. Leadership, when Captain Gwenmerica uses it and succeeds, she may also remove an action token from a friendly character that shares a keyword with her from anywhere on the map. That's Avengers, Spider-Man Family, and Soldier. And then her other trait is the Avengers, which they all have. When Captain Gwenmerica hits, after resolutions, you may move all friendly characters with this trait up to one square, makes them pretty mobile. She has a special speed power that's charge, running shot, and stealth. No matter what starting line, she has that for her first 4 clicks, and her 35-point line starts on click 4. But yeah, I think if you're running the Avengers, you definitely need your leadership.
You need her, yeah.
And yeah,
you definitely do.
Starting with that defend and outwit, she's pretty solid. Also, I mean, not for nothing, she does just work good with other soldiers and Avengers. So
yeah,
there's that. Ooh, and not only a hint card, but also the set list card.
Hey, nice.
So we can start checking things off.
Yeah, I hope you've been keeping track at home with your set list cards for this video. I don't know why you would. All right, well, we've pulled, a Super Rare Prime, 2 Super Rares, and a Chase
and
now.
And a Chase, yeah.
I don't know what else we could get in this, but, I mean, hopefully another Rare Symbiote. I want an army of those. Those guys
oh, yeah.
are awesome. I pulled it. I'm not even kidding. I swear I didn't see that. We have a Rare Symbiote. I got to play him in Sealed, and he was incredible tie-up, but we'll go over him in just a second. We've got a police officer, Black Cat, Gwen Stacy, the Matt Murdock who makes the bandages
oh,
that you were talking about earlier.
Evil
and this
Murdock.
One, he's rocking the all-red.
Yeah.
Amazing.
He's evil.
And then Symbiote, who, I don't know how that happened, but I swear I did not see that in the back. Alright guys, let's take a look at Symbiote. This is honestly one of my favorite designs in the entire set. I absolutely love what they did with this trait, finding a new host. So when Symbiote is KO'd, after resolutions, you may equip a S006 Symbiote Black equipment from your sideline onto a friendly character within 4 squares of the square last occupied. If there is no friendly character within 4 squares, you may instead generate that equipment from your sideline in the square symbiote last occupied. So the symbiote's hopping off this generic host, because it says real name Varius on the back, and it's going on to somebody on your team, or it's coming on the map. I really, really like that. I think that's so much fun, and I hope to see more traits designed like that in the future. But he's also got charge, leap climb, plasticity, and stealth for 30 points.
Yeah.
So he's getting anywhere he needs to be, and then he's locking him down with that plasticity. And on top of that, he's got shape change on the dial, and his defense ability is Super Sense's Toughness. When Symbiote is dealt damage from Energy Explosion or Quake, also give it an action token, so a little more flavor with the Symbiote.
Right.
We all remember Spider-Man 3.
Yeah, just steel pipes, I guess?
Yeah, he whips them into the ground and starts banging on them, so...
Yeah.
Straight from the movie, guys. Incredible. So yeah, that's Symbiote, and that puts me at 2. If you have some symbiotes that you don't want, please get in contact with me.
Definitely a fun, a flavorful generic.
Yeah, one of the best, seriously.
Just so much going on, and it's like it's all just like so good. Like I can turn this into an object, like it morphs off of that person onto like the next person.
Hopping onto another one of your figures is so cool.
He can start with the
symbiote too.
Oh yeah, so you can
drop two. Yeah.
All right. Next pack, we've got J. Jonah Jameson. We've got another common hand ninja. We've got Bullseye, one of my personal favorites in Sealed. We've got an uncommon Spider-Man, and then we've got the rare Electro, who's got the whole prob and enhancement on dial. Definitely helped me take down a Venom Thanos because of that enhancement. Electro, again, part of the Frightful Four and Sinister Syndicate with the Sinister Syndicate team ability. Comes in at 75 or 50 points. The Rally 6 on Electro is, it's kind of like a chain shot. Like, if you hit and you remove one of your rally dice, you can make it a range attack as if you occupied the hit character squares.
So very reminiscent to the Amazing Spider-Man Electro, the uncommon one they did, who could arc back and forth between, I think it was new targets. I can't remember exactly how it worked, but you could target from other people's square. It was really cool.
Yeah, the chain lightning. And then, of course, his damage power, maximum voltage, that's the enhancement prob control power. Very economical little piece. I found him necessary and sealed, just because the pulse wave to get around super senses, and then prob is at a hot commodity. Also, Bullseye's rally ability, you have to get 2 red rally sixes, but if you use it, next time like you attack and you remove 2 of them, you replace both die in the attack roll with a 6. So it becomes an instant crit hit. Doesn't matter what you rolled.
I just always love seeing Bullseye too.
Yeah.
I love his costume, love his character. He's just awesome.
He is one of those bad guys that's just like so fun to have in comics, because he's
always bad, like, in a good too. Way. Like Heroclix, he's always been good. Even going back to like Infinity Challenge, Bullseye has always been a ton of fun to play.
But
we got one more. Ooh.
Pardon the pun, but that is a very accurate Bullseye, because he's very accurate.
Now tell me this isn't some last pack magic, Simeon.
Ooh.
Isn't that just amazing here? I wish you guys could feel it at home, but this one, it's a winner. And of course, it's a winner. It's a winner, all right, guys. Because to end this unboxing, we have Morbius, the man himself. It's Morbius's time.
It is Morbius's time.
We also got I haven't seen this Rhino in person yet. That's huge.
Yeah.
He's massive.
He both looks like thick and extremely muscular at the same time.
Yeah, thick, rough, muscular. Interesting. We also have Hand Ninja Uncommon again. We've got the Spiderling Common, and then another police officer as well. So, let's go ahead and pop out Morbius. Let's take a look at him, because it is his time. All right. So he's got one trait, Hunger for Plasma. Morbius starts the game on click number 4. Steel energy, when Morbius uses it, he may heal past his starting line. So, classic vampire dial, love to see that. He's also got traded stealth. He's only 50 points as well. He's starting with charge blades. Sinister Syndicate TA and Spider-Man TA, both fantastic. And getting him healed up, like...
That top dial, or even click 2. I mean,
click 2. Like, it is kind of unfortunate that click 4 and click 3 are the same, so if you do heal up once, like, you are going to have to hit multiple times to really get the rewards for that. But on the other end of that, he's only 50 points, and he's rocking a 9-click dial, technically 6, because he starts on click 4, but I really like him. I think he's really solid. He's got some good keywords as well. Spider-Man Family, Sinister Syndicate, Monster, Scientist, Midnight Suns, which I would love to see more of.
Yeah.
And then very quickly, let's just take a peek at this Rhino, because, wow, he is rocking a 9-click dial. Holy.
He is the stoutest. This is the reason, like, him alone is the reason why you consider playing that Prime, that Iron Spider Prime, because imagine trying to get through this dial without Outwit.
I mean,
it's rough.
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, his Rally 2 looks like when Rhino moves and destroys one or more pieces of terrain after resolutions, may remove one of his Rally dice to deal one damage to each opposing character that was adjacent to one or more pieces of destroyed terrain. It's a good way to get some free damage out. No other specials, just a 9-click dial. Man, getting him in Sealed.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of Outwit in this set.
No, there's not.
He would be really hard to deal with. He's also destroying blocking. Yeah, okay. I'm a fan of this Rhino. I like him. But yeah, that's the brick. Any closing statements you have, Simeon?
No, as I said at the beginning of this, keep an eye out with the IPF. Some of this will become prizing. We do have some other videos showcasing like the starter set, the play-at-home kits, dice and token pack. We'll be releasing those later, but we wanted to let you guys see what distribution might be like for sealed pulls and stuff like that, and just give you some first thoughts on everything. So,
yeah. And guys, the IPF tournament online is coming up April 1st. It'll be at 12 Central. We do have a video on that. Go ahead, check that one out. And please get in contact with us. Come play with us online and let's raise some money for a good cause. Until next time, this has been Beyond Amazing with Ian and Simeon. Yeah.